ये साउंड खराब है भाई। एक काम करो, बूम रखे अपने।
हाँ बूम ही रखी,
बूम ही रखती हूँ।
Hi, good afternoon everyone. Welcome. We are here for 3x3 Pro Basketball League, which is one of its kind FIBA recognized basketball league in India. And we have here with us renowned filmmaker Mr. Mahesh Bhatt, actor filmmaker Ms. Pooja Bhatt, league commissioner Mr. Rohit Bakshi, co-owner of Delhi who was along with Ms. Pooja Bhatt, Mr. Vivek Singh, players from the Delhi team Leandro Souza de Lima, Kiran Shastri, Indraveer Gill and Vikramjeet Gill. Before we start, we want to give you a glimpse of what 3x3 basketball is and what we are doing here. So here we have a video. As you saw, 3x3 basketball is a unique sport which was originated from the streets and now it's going to be played in the 2020 Tokyo Olympics. 3BL is one of the first FIBA, is the first FIBA recognized basketball league in India. And I invite Mahesh ji to speak about, say something about the league. About the league. Can we get a mic?
Well, when you step into your wisdom years, the child whom you taught ball teaches you ball again. बचपन में हमने इनके हाथ में एक बॉल थमाया था, अभी ये हमको हमारे बुढ़ापे में बॉल थमा रही हैं। तो मैं तो अपनी बेटी की नौकरी करने आया हूँ यहाँ पर। इन्होंने इशारा किया, डैडी आई वॉन्ट यू देयर, सो आई एम हियर, बट आई एम हियर बिकॉज शी इज सपोर्टिंग समथिंग विच इज सो लाइफ अफर्मिंग इन दिस एज एंड टाइम व्हेन वी आर जस्ट फॉलिंग अपार्ट एंड गेटिंग मोर एंड मोर आइसोलेटेड. Here is this game of basketball which makes you understand that it's only the collective power of a group of people that can achieve miracles. And as the AV was playing, she was whispering in my ear that it is the first time you have a sport which has responded to the digital age where the attention deficit disorder is a reality. It's a 10-minute game where these guys give their hearts and their entire being and either lose and go into the bowels of despair or are ecstatic and jump to the top of the moon. But then, whether they win or they lose, they start all over again, like life. And what is so great about basketball, Rohit, and this trade of mine called movies, is we are humbled from movie to movie. No matter how big a hit we have got, the next time we go into the cinema hall with a movie, the chances of us facing a disaster are almost certain. So it keeps us on the ground, our feet on the ground, makes us realize that we never know the game really. And I bet any serious player knows that no matter how well you have played, the chances of you coming out a loser are more than coming out a winner. And there's always somebody somewhere better than you. So I think this is what is the need of the hour. As the world falls apart, let us create an awareness to bring people together, the young people together, the youth together. The youth who suffer from attention deficit disorder would be very, very attracted to a sport like this. When you could redesign for five-day cricket to 2020, I think that was just because the adrenal rush was something that people needed. So I think basketball is a new bird in town. And I think I love beginnings. I love mornings. I love the flowers blooming. Whenever I see somebody taking the first baby step into the journey of life, I am just filled with dreams for that individual. And I think basketball is doing that. Basketball in India is taking that first baby step. So please, all of you, get up and support it. Because enough of supporting only one sport. You can't be talking about a plural society where you talk about there is diversity and there's room for everybody, and give a stepmotherly treatment to such a brave sport which is designed for the 21st century, second decade. So I'm here to support this, and I'm here to support these very bright, young, vibrant people who have given their hearts to this game. And I'll be there again tomorrow. And whenever you call me, wherever you call me, I will give everything I have to make this sport into a big, big star. Thank you.
Very well, sir. Thank you so much, Mahesh ji. Pooja ji, would you like to say something?
I think as always, he summed it all up. But I think that, you know, I just want to take you back to an experience we had. We were at the World Two Masters in Japan together. And they lost that game. And I remember going to meet all of them and kind of saying that tonight is the night we must celebrate. And I told them all about what my father taught me about failure. And I said, my father told me that you must celebrate your failure more than you celebrate your success. Because failure is going to happen. Flop film to hum banayenge hi. Hit hogi ya nahi pata nahi, magar flop to hum banayenge hi. And you must at this point hold on to this feeling, or feeling reduced to that. Use this kind of feeling and as fuel, and propel yourself even higher in the next round. That's exactly what they did. So I remember sitting there holding all their hands in Japan and quoting you, Mr. Bhatt, about failure and how enriching failure is.
You know, it comes from the Gita. It was Lord Krishna tells Arjun, bring me your failures. So this is something which has come from our heritage. Failures leave you richer. I would never give my failures away to anybody. I can trade my successes, never my failures. I have failed my way to success. And that's what I've learned about basketball. That when they join, they're told, no, you're not good enough. You can't make it. Like the same with the movies. You're not good enough. You can't make it. Oh, he can't make it. He's finished. One thing common about the basketball spirit and the entertainment spirit, or about life, the spirit that you, the game that you belong to, is to keep on going no matter what happens.
True. And I think that when I look back at the last 2 months, and tomorrow is going to be our last round of this league, and I'm actually quite sad it's coming to an end, because these 2 months have really zipped past. And I fell into basketball by accident, and before the media in Delhi, when we launched it, could even ask me what I really knew about it. I quoted your boss, Raj Khosla, who asked you what you knew about filmmaking when you went to get your first job. And he said, Mr. Bhatt, you want to be an assistant film director to me, but what do you know about filmmaking on a scale from 0 to 10? So he said, 0. So Raj Khosla sahab ne kaha ki 0 is a great place to start. So for me, it was 0 as far as basketball was concerned, but that was the great place for me to start. And when I watched them on court, I see the similarities between what we do in our profession and what they do in their profession, where we are uncertain, we are unsure. Things don't happen by hoping. Not in sport, not in cinema. You've got to go out there and you've got to put yourself on fire, and you've got to give every iota an inch of yourself and burn for people to respond to that. So I think it's been the most enriching 2 months for me, because it's allowed me to step away from my insular world of movies and step into a life and meet people whose intent is so pure, starting with Rohit, who's doing this because he truly loves basketball and has been a player himself. And I was telling just Indies this last night, I said, I did not know at the age of 46, I would suddenly have a whole new bunch of people to claim shamelessly as my own, because they're friends and family and so much more to me. So I'm just very grateful, and I think that in a world that's saturated with cricket, it's like Bollywood. Everyone believes that Bollywood is it, and we kind of give regional cinema a very stepmotherly treatment, when a lot of the gold is coming out of the regional cinema. So while cricket is our mainstay, we've all grown up watching it, but I think that basketball, like other sports like boxing, squash, are the underdogs. And I've learned one thing from my father, is that the industry and the world in general does not need new people. We need new eyes to be able to look at people, put your conviction and belief behind them, and then they can just kind of really, really reach tantalizing heights. So I think that if there's anything that me and Mr. Bhatt bring to the table, it is our conviction. And we want to put all our conviction behind this nascent kind of step and the stage that basketball is in, to be part of this glorious beginning. We've had a great tour so far and a great kind of five rounds. My team won 4 out of 5, and I'm hoping they'll kind of win this weekend as well. And then, of course, now we go on to Mexico, and then go on to Hyderabad, where the first time you have the World Tour happening in Hyderabad, in India. And then we've got the Olympics and the Commonwealth after that, and I think that they stand a really fair chance. So unlike the officials who wait for an athlete to go out there and make a mark and then claim their success, not unlike filmmakers and producers who write off a filmmaker, don't believe in the subject, and when it kind of becomes a big hit, you say, "Gaane bhi maine banaye, dialogue bhi maine likhe hain, sab kuch maine kiya hai." That's the same thing with basketball, which is why I kind of went against protocol and expressed my displeasure about the BFI, because I feel that if you cannot help somebody, then at least don't create a roadblock. An actor and an athlete is not different. When you get the opportunity to go out there and hone your skill, people in charge need to allow them to do that. It's like telling an actor that you can work in a film, but you can't work on television. Who decides the medium? Who says that somebody who plays in 5BL cannot play in 3BL? Jo T20 mein khelta hai, kya wo test match nahi khel sakta? So I think that, you know, when we talk about sportsmanship, the people and the powers that be that decide for sport need to learn a little bit of sportsmanship and the capacity to be able to step back and give the athletes of India what they want and what they need for us to truly make a mark on the world stage. What stops us from doing that is our attitude, our very own. हम दूसरे तो से तो लड़ लेंगे मगर हमारे खुद से कौन अब हमको बचाने वाला है. That's the question I want to ask. So now I think that let's not make this, keep this a monologue. I think let's make this a kind of a dialogue. So we've got our players here, we've got Rohit right here. If anyone's got any questions, throw them at us. And there's one more video Rohit wants to show you.
Thank you so much for inspiring words, Pooja ji. Rohit sir, would you like to add anything?
Rohit sir, please say nice things about me.
I will. Thank you so much, Mahesh ji, and thank you so much, Pooja ji. I mean, for a basketball lover, I've been playing basketball ever since I remember. It's been too long, and I was. It's never too long for a thing you love, and basketball has been my dream. And to starting a league is something which is my vision. This is something happened with a lot of people's support, not just Pooja ji, and now Mahesh ji is with us. He has given us a lot of kind words. I've gone through a lot of hard time. Now we reach to this level. There's a lot of players, all these players right here that you see, including myself, we all gone through a hard time. We had a good times, we had a bad times. But this season, I don't want to bore you. I will show you what we have done. Please go through this 2 minutes video. This is regarding what we have done in this first season as a 3x3 basketball.
very interesting thing you'll notice is that, you know, what they've done, which is exceptional, is that they're taking the sport to people. They're not waiting for people to come to stadiums. And I think that is what's most special about this league, is that we're holding it in venues like malls, because we want the footfall of people who are not really sports viewers or sports fans, but people who are coming there just to spend a day, and then they discover the sport and they get that rush. So the idea is to make it accessible and bring it to you. And that is the point that should be driven home. It's very important.
So now we can start the question answers. I request you to ask questions related to the sport, and please introduce yourself before asking the questions. But first, as a basketball enthusiast myself, Rohit sir, I'd like to ask you a question. What was the idea behind the birth of 3BL?
So the idea behind 3BL was I wanted to start a professional basketball league in India to give a professional career to all those basketball people. We do not have any professional league in India. And it's not because we don't have a talent. It's not because we don't have a resources. It's just that nobody had with the right vision, with the right resources. And there was a lot of hurdles in between. In basketball, there are two different formats, 5-on-5 and then 3x3. I met 3x3 in 2015. I was searching for the right angle. And when I met 3x3 for the first time, I realized this is the format where Indian can actually perform. And I wanted to prove that. In 2016, Bikramjeet Gill, Inderbir Singh, and myself, there was one more player who is currently in NBA, Amjot Singh. We four of us formed the team. We played in Japan. The reason why we played in Japan is, one, because I'm from Japan, and Japan was the only place they have a professional basketball league at that time. 2016, we played in the league, and we won the championship. And FIBA offers a world stage, which is called World Tour Masters. We play two World Tour Masters. Then we qualify for the World Tour Final, which is equivalent to a World Cup of 3x3. For the first season, for the first year, we became number second in the entire world. We proved the entire nation, we proved the entire world that Indians can ball. And when FIBA came back to us, they came back to us with a idea that, where did I find these guys? You know, the guy's from Canada, he's from US, and I'm from Japan. And Amjot was from Chandigarh. Then I explained all where that happened, and what FIBA told me was, what I did for these guys, do it for my country. And that's how all this started.
Can I add? Yes. I think Rohit's not telling you that he was basically told by somebody that Indians don't know how to handle a basketball, and he wanted to prove them wrong. Am I right?
Yes, actually, to add to that, journey started with Inderbir. I met Inderbir in 2011, and I wanted him to play professionally. He's my dear friend, and he's one of the most talented Indian origin guy you ever meet. And sorry, Bacon, sorry, Ken, but you know, that's what it is. When I was introducing him in Japan, one, they said he's too short. He's 6 feet, but basketball is short. And then second, this is Indian can't even hold the basketball. So as a Punjabi, I mean, you know, I see Punjabi guy there. So, you know, it's like when you say this kind of stuff, I was born and raised in that country, and they didn't accept it. And when I got that insult for the first time, I was like, koi baat nahi, bolenge nahi, karke dikhayenge. Aapke ghar mein karke dikhayenge. And that's what we did in 2016.
So you spoke about people saying Indians can't play basketball, but after this league, after 5 rounds, do you think Indians have an opportunity to win a gold or any medal at Olympics or Commonwealth Games?
See, I'm a basketball person, so for me, whatever comes out is something, you know, I'm always going to say a good thing for basketball. Let's address this to Pooja ji.
Yes, 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 yes. Mr. Bhatt, you want to kind of add to that and say yes?
Yes.
This sport has become an Olympic sport and a medal sport, and also in Commonwealth. This will be introduced in 2020 and 2022, Birmingham Commonwealth. And the entire idea of starting a league this year is so that, you know, we could have a first mover advantage to be to bring basketball in Olympic and win a medal in Olympic. I strongly believe we can do that.
Thank you. You can ask. We can start with the questions now.
Sir, the 3x3, there is a 10-minute game, 21 points or 10 minutes, whichever come first. So this is one of the sports where they have a knockout. So if you score 21 points, game is over, or 10 minutes, whoever has the higher score. 4 players, 3 plays, 1 sub. Sir, Pooja ji batayenge aapko 10 minutes kitna lamba ho sakta hai.
That's true, when we have to tell a story, 10 minutes can be very long, and then 1 minute, and then one, that is the whole concept of 10 minutes is changed in my own head, believe me, after I've been introduced to basketball. But I think like Bhatt Saab said earlier, we're living in time, sir, which is, people have got very less attention span. People want to watch movies on their phone. The entire short film kind of slot was not that popular as it is now. People want their entertainment, they want their sport, they want everything to become more concise. And this caters to exactly that. That's what Bhatt Saab said. This is a sport for the second half of the 21st century in the real sense of the word. What cricket did with T20, and they were told by the people that, you know, you cannot bastardize cricket like that, you can't make it shorter, you can't make it swifter, you can't make it faster. That's what they've done with basketball. And it kind of sweeps you in. For someone like me who was not a basketball fan in that sense, I mean, if I'm swept up, I do know that there'll be a million people out there who will be as well, because you can't help but be. It's very exciting, it's very fast, it's entertaining. They are very entertaining, these players, I must say. There's some great performances out there that you have to see sometimes. And it caters to the times that we live in, where people don't have focus. It is a fact that now people, the average person's attention span is actually now 8 seconds. We know that in the world of entertainment. We certainly know that in the world of news and media. So it's the Twitter format as opposed to the Facebook format. You got to get in there, you got to make your point, and you got to get out. If not, somebody else will make it, you know, stronger than you. Bite kya hai? What is the headline? That's it. So basketball is the headline. 3x3 is the headline, really.
And the attention economy, the whole thing is about attention. We live in the age called the attention economy, where getting attention is the be-all and the end-all. And 10 minutes is a long time. We in the movie world know 10 minutes is one reel. Yeah. And one reel can make or break a film. When we release promos, which are 30 seconds, our destiny is sealed. It sets the tone. So I think 10 minutes in this age and time is the unit in which you can make your point tremendously and effectively and pander to the generation which is now your generation, which is watching content on their flat screen. This is your window to the world. So I think there's the major cultural revolution took place when man moved from the text to the image. And I think the image reaches the consciousness much faster than the written word does. And that's what I think basketball is, the new age sport.
Yeah.
Well, the biggest problem is to get the very busy media's attention and demand their time. I call people, key people in the media, and I said I would never ask for a film, but I am shamelessly demanding for basketball. I need all of your support, because we need to move away from, you know, our lead actor called cricket and give other people a little bit more attention. We were just talking about Irfan Khan today, in fact, to somebody, and I said that, you know, we cast him in Rogue as a hero for the first time, and unfortunately it took Angelina Jolie to cast her gaze on him for India to start taking Irfan Khan seriously. So why are we waiting for basketball and 3BL to first go out there and win a medal before we give it its rightful place in the sun? We need to recognize, we need to back, and we need to push our very own, and not wait for somebody outside to recognize us before we wake up to what is there in our backyard.
And it's never too late. If I can do it at 69, you can begin now.
The problems that we did face, and that's something that I stumbled upon, was that actually the roadblock created by the BFI, where they kind of sent out a letter to other players and referees saying that if you take part in 3BL, we will not permit you to take part in other matches and other tournaments. And I think that was completely myopic on their behalf, because I keep comparing to actors. When you are an artist, when you're an athlete, you have to go out there and hone your skill. And with a sport that's already niche, the powers that be should be encouraging people to get more exposure and allow them to get paid. Rohit is doing this because he wants to see basketball players making money in crores like we've always seen cricket players do. Kabaddi was written off when it first started. Look where it's gone now. So we want the same thing for basketball, and we would like the powers that be to actually, if not help us, at least not create roadblocks, and at least come and applaud us and say, hey, well done. Because that's what we work for, that's what we perform for, that's what we play for.
Hello, Bhart sir.
Hi.
Pooja ma'am. Pooja ma'am has been missing you from Silver Skin. My question is like, you know, you're from Bollywood. Bhart sir has given maximum hits from Bollywood. What made you to get into sports and that too basketball?
I came into it by chance, and I must thank my ex-husband, who's not here right now, Munish Makhija, and Ritvik Bhattacharya, who actually kind of introduced me to Vivek Singh and to Mr. Rao, who are my co-owners in Delhi Hoopers, and said, you know, we're supporting the basketball league. And my first question was, what do I know about basketball? Because I'm not a dial-a celebrity. You can't get me to endorse something merely for a fee, and if my heart is not in the right place with regards to it. But I came there because my friends were involved, and I did know that basketball is the underdog, like squash and boxing and kabaddi was. And I get from him this habit of supporting the underdog. And I think that cricket doesn't need me. There are enough voices out there. Cricket doesn't need any of us. But I think that it's a business and a country and a place and times where conviction is in short supply. And I think my applause is contagious, which is why I stepped away from being an actor to sitting in the audience and being a filmmaker and launching new people, because I felt that if I applaud somebody, other people kind of get the audacity to applaud them as well. So I wanted to bring that forward. When I watched them the first time and I watched the first tournament, I was just swept up with the entire thing. And I loved what I saw. I loved meeting them, and I just thought there was a click that happened in my heart. And I told them, I said, now you've had it, because now I'm going to follow you everywhere you go. And I told Rohit, I said, you're not going to have me as a mere owner of a team in that sense. I wanted to be involved, and I have gotten involved in more ways than one, because I think that the intention of everybody sitting here is so pure. And what they're trying to do is so brave and courageous. And I think that, forget about me giving. Basketball in the last 2 months in this 3BL, whole tour has given me so much. It's allowed me to step away from my insular world of movies, because filmmakers, actors become very insular. Baatein wahi hoti hai. Kiski film chal gayi, kiski film nahi chal gayi, kaun kya kar raha hai? There's a world out there beyond cinema, and I've been allowed through this to be able to immerse myself in that world, meet people that I would never have met before, and who today I can confidently say are going to be part of my journey for the rest of my life. So I would say thank you to you and to all of you wonderfully lovely, beautiful men sitting here on this podium with me, because it's given me a chance to go out there and experience a whole new world, a whole new life, and I come away enriched.
Have you tried your hands?
I know what I can do and I know what I cannot do. Like, jabhi bhi hum interview dete hain, log puchte ki aap gana gaiye na, agar main gana gaati, main acting kyun karti? And if I could sing, I could rule the world. If I could play basketball, I would rule the world too. But I'm there as their cheerleader. I applaud them.
I want to try my hand.
ये तो नेचुरल बॉर्न एथलीट है हर बार गिरना फिर उठना और फिर कॉन्स्टेंटली
हम पिलाटिस करते हैं पिलाटिस रोज सुबह जाते हैं जिमनेजियम में और शॉक करते हैं हमारी बच्चियों को कि ये
भाई को जो बॉडी बिल्डर है वैसे
कि ये क्या हो गया इनको हमने बोला एक नई सुबह है तो ये ऊर्जा जो है बड़ी कंटेजियस है इनकी इनके साथ बैठने से कुछ एक अजीब ही नशा आता है आई थिंक वो नशा उसका लुत्फ लेने हम आए हैं यहाँ पर
रोहित सर लाइक एज यू सेड दैट यू वुड लाइक टू मेक इंडियन बास्केटबॉल प्लेयर्स यू नो अर्न करोड़ सो डू यू हैव एनी यू नो प्लान्ड आउटलाइन फॉर दैट फॉर फ्यूचर लाइक दैट वुड अलाउ यू टू यू नो मेक इट
You're talking about roadmap.
You said that you have you would like to you know make Indian basketball players to earn in crores. So, do you have any plan for future?
How do I plan?
Yeah.
Okay. So the entire plan is I have a goal set for 2018, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So there are two Olympics comes in this between, one Commonwealth which comes in between. 3x3, this is a very new sport in the entire world. FIBA recognizes sports in 2012. And ever since, this is growing massively. And so one of the way is, so this season, if you are a 3x3 bowler, and if you're playing in a World Tour and Challenger and a World Tour final, the combined winning prize is $1 million. And FIBA is increasing that value every single year. Now, let's calculate, right? 4 years down the line, next year is going to be 2 million, then it's going to be 4 million, then it's going to be 8 million. There are four players. Let's say they are winning majority of it. Calculation start coming up, right? But that's only for the four players. I need a lot of support, one, as Pujaji said, from the media. India mein jo dikhta hai, wo bikhta hai. That is something I've learned in this past 9 years. Duniya mein, I would say. India mein, like, I'm very new to this country. I came to this country 9 years ago with a different vision. Then I realized there's so much potential in every single sector, and sports was one of them. And I feel if I have a lot of support from the media, more exposure that I have, I can have more sponsors coming in. I have more owners coming in. More sponsors coming in, more endorsement will happen. So it's all depend on how much we get loved by the media people and how this news, how this sports, how this format, how this player get displayed in through your cameras, your newspaper, and your digital channel.
So like last week also we had one interview with you. So there you had mentioned there are always three elements which are required to any sport to have success.
Yes.
Yeah. So like one is like interviewing rivalry, media coverage, and the breakout star. So how close are you know, achieving this with 3x3 basketball?
So let me elaborate, right? So three things. I believe, Mahesh, please add me if my philosophy is wrong. So I believe... So sir, I believe any sport... any sport to get successful, it needs to have a star. It needs to have a rivalry. Like India-Pakistan, aap kaam chhod ke TV dekhte hain. Right? You need a rivalry. Right now we have, so they're the same team, but they're not. He's in Mumbai, he's in Delhi. So they have a rivalry.
My heart gets split into two and they're playing each other.
But that's a rivalry going on. So we are already establishing that for, but because this is just the first season, it's very too soon to say. So we have a stars, but we are almost there with a rivalry, and we are very, very minimum in terms of media, in terms of what needs to be seen. It needs to be on a TV, it needs to be on a media, it needs to be told to people that this is the sport which is gonna make a next mark in India, where I require a lot of your help, a lot of your support, a lot of your love. If I have these three, whatever we can do for the player, that can automatically happen.
So as you know, this Tokyo Olympic is like 3 years away. So 2 years, sorry, 2 years away. So do you think Indian basketball is good enough to send 3x3 to compete there?
One, we need to qualify first. So there's an algorithm in FIBA 3x3. So the 3x3, again, let me come back to the original route. Hello? Yeah. So the reason why 3x3 format was, one, there's a beach volleyball and volleyball, football and futsal. Everything is becoming short, everything is becoming faster. 3x3 was a vision for the developing countries like us. We cannot compete in 5-on-5, not for at least next 30 years. But 3x3 we can. And that is what we have proved in 2016. I'm not just saying, we have proved it. We became number second. We were this close to win the championship. Right? If we could do that, we could do it again, right? And what I feel is in 3x3, we have, because we have a first mover advantage, and because not many countries, even US is not ready, Canada is not ready, most of the East European countries has realized this opportunity, and now they are putting so much pressure. 3x3, top 10 teams in the world are East Europeans. It's not US, it's not Canada, it's not Brazil, it's not Australia, it's not China. That's where I thought there's the opportunity there. If we are, so there is an algorithm for us to put us in Olympic. For that, I require a lot of support from my own nation. And if that get through, and with the league and with the right competitions, we have an international player competing against Indian players, and we have a best of the best talent to play in the league, I strongly believe we have a very good chance of winning a gold medal in 2020.
Thank you, sir. So again, my question, Rohit, sir. Thing is, what support you got from Association of Basketball in India? Did they supported you for your venture? And well, also,
may I please add, instead of supporting, they have attempted to create roadblocks.
Okay.
When the BFI issues a letter to players and referees and says that if you participate in the 3BL, we will not permit you from taking part in other tournaments, what does that mean? One thing is ki aap hame support nahi kar rahe hain, aap phir aap letter likhwa rahe hain ki agar aap inke saath kaam karenge hum aapko kaam nahi denge. I found that rather deplorable, and I had to state that, because I feel that when we look at our authorities and we look at people who are supposedly there in positions of power, they are there because we have given them that power, and it is our right to question that. I don't think it's a sign of irreverence. It's very well to say Puja Bhatt slams or Puja Bhatt cries foul. I'm asking a pertinent question. This is a niche sport in India. If your players are getting the opportunity to be able to go and play off other players who've had world exposure, participate, hone their skill and get paid for it, how can an authority or a governing body prevent that? How can they morally prevent that is the question I am asking. And I don't buy this hogwash of, oh no, we've taken a good decision because if they take part in 3BL, then they can't take part. No. An actor is an actor is an actor. A cricketer is a cricketer is a cricketer. There's a cricketer who does not take part in T20 prevented from taking part anywhere else. So why is this applicable to basketball is the question I'm asking loudly and clearly to the BFI, who's a self-appointed authority of this country. And I'm sorry, but if you are our seniors and if you are people who decide for us, then we have the right to question you. Because you're preventing us from going out there and claiming our space in the sun on a world stage. And when athletes do it, this tour has been successful despite the BFI. And I would like to underline that. And only when they go out there and achieve what they have to is when people will step in and say, ah, we've done it. It's not unlike movies that we've made. Aashiqui 2, nobody believed in. They wrote off the film, they wrote off the music, they wrote off the actors. Hit ho gayi film, to sab log aa gaye phir bolne ke liye ki gaane humne banaye hain, dialogue humne likhe hain, actor humne chune hain. So it's the same thing. And I have been trained by him to question, to ask, and expect an answer for something that is morally and inherently wrong. So support? You're kidding me. Roadblocks is what I'm crying foul about, because it has happened and we've got proof of that. We've got letters in our possession which were written by the secretary of the BFI. Two other, it's not only about players, referees for example. He wanted senior referees, he couldn't get access to them. So what happens? What happens when you don't get senior referees? Then your game is becoming slower, it's telling on the game. So I mean, you know, we can't be so myopic and you can't let personal egos come into play. It's very important that if you cannot help, then you at least don't prevent me from going ahead on my own. Silence of everybody.
I think whenever you question people's power to control you, there is a stone silence there in the bureaucracy. And I think it is our duty to keep on persistently questioning them. Because as you said, this is a sport which is a contemporary expression of the contemporary times we're living in, and they better make room for it. If they don't have any past references, of course you don't have. There's a new age, there's a new world, there's a new energy. There are people who are doing it for you. Gracefully listen to what they're saying and gracefully create systems to encourage it.
Yes, and adapt. Like they say in our business, I mean, originality is one thing, creativity is one thing, but relevance is the most difficult thing of it all. Mahesh Bhatt is relevant today, unlike many other filmmakers from his generation. It's not about the movies he makes or does not make. It's about the man who's upgraded himself with the times that he's lived in. So if we have people in power who run our federations, they need to upgrade themselves with new formats and new ways of functioning and say, hey, this is also something relevant and valid. And like Rohit said, there is a mainstay of the Americans in a certain aspect of basketball, which is the 5BL. Here we truly have a great shot. Should our authorities be tying our hands up or telling us, go fly, we are there to back you up? That's a question I'm asking. And the silence to my answer says it all.
The success is already in your pocket this year. So you think next year they'll come forward to support you?
That's something that Rohit should answer. But I think that, you know, at the end of the day, I mean, my point is that either help me if you want to, either you're on my side or get out of my way, is what I believe. Because we're forging ahead. And this will get bigger. This will get better. And people from my own fraternity, it's like you wait for someone to kind of be the first one to get up and clap, or someone casts the first stone, and then before you know it, it's a riot, right? So I do know that once this goes from strength to strength, we'll have more people coming in. And the day this league loses its purity and its innocence, you won't see me on this stage. So that's right now, it's pure, it's innocent, and I'm hoping that more people come forth, invest in it. And also people from my fraternity come out there and kind of, I've got Mohit Suri, my cousin who made a movie called Half Girlfriend, to come and watch the finals on Sunday. I said, aapne film banayi hai kab basketball pe, come on, applaud my athletes. So he's coming. So I think that what we don't ask for our own movies, we're shamelessly asking for this, that this needs your support. And it's in your hands to give it the place that it truly deserves, because, you know, we can't just focus on Bollywood and cricket all the time. I mean, come on, change the rhetoric for God's sake, guys. Why is Mahesh Bhatt and me sitting here? Because there are a lot of things that we see in common with our profession and theirs. And at the end of the day, we need to support the underdog, because, I mean, you know, it's a David and Goliath situation. So we need to be out there, relevant, move with the times, and see things before the world does.
I think Bhatt is really serious, very serious about playing this game. So he's practicing, sitting there.
Feel of the ball, and I really want to play with these giants on in the arena.
Okay, so the entire format of 3BL, we are hopping in different cities, and we have done our 5 different cities. This is our final round in Mumbai. The entire structure is we have 19 matches in 2 days. There are going to be 12 matches starting 2 p.m. And every third match, there's going to be entertainment. So we have put 70% game, 30% entertainment to it. Yes, so it's going to be a Phoenix Market City, Kurla. It's about, I think it's right down the road from here. It's about 10 minutes from here. And it's going to be inside the mall. The entire concept is, as Pujaji said earlier, of 3BL is bringing the sports to a people, not people to us. So this is the only sports in India which is conducting in a mall. And we are a first professional league to conduct in a mall to showcase to a people who are non-basketball fan. The entire purpose is to increase the awareness of the sport and make more fans to it.
Well, first of all, man, it's a blessing just to be sitting here with such great people. Feel honored to be here. I want to thank you guys for being here. For 3BL, man, it's been amazing. Came here about 6 months ago. Like Rohit mentioned earlier, you know, we go way back. This guy gave me an opportunity to play professional basketball, and it's putting food on the table. You know, I'm earning money from this, you know, which you can't really ask for anything else as an athlete. Right? This is my passion from day, you know, since I was born, to play this game professionally, and to be able to do this in India, coming back here from US, is truly, man, amazing. And I'm so grateful for, you know, all of these guys to give me this chance. And yeah, man, let's rock this weekend.
Oh,
I just have a few words. Basketball for me is, I mean, for everybody that's here that plays, it's like a passion, it's like a dream. And, you know, I'm not supposed to be here right now, you know, like, and, you know, God has given me, like, a lot to be thankful for. And that's, like Indy said, you know, it's basically a ball you put in a hoop, and, you know, and it's great, and we're getting paid for it, and it puts food on the table for us. And, you know, it's thanks to Royth over there. You know, he believed in us coming out of college. You know, I didn't have any opportunity, and, you know, he gave me the opportunity. And now we're 3 years down the line, and, you know, this league has started, and now it's the end of the league, you know, in Mumbai, final round. And, you know, everything is going by so fast. And, like, I just want to say, like, end of the season one, sorry. Not the end, but the end of season one. And, you know, it's like, it's great because, you know, we have passion in our sport, and these two people have passion in what they do and make movies and stuff. And, you know, it's great to see, like, we're big fans of them, and we support them, and we've seen their movies and all like that, and they come and support us, and, you know, they become fans and watch us play, you know, and it's like, it's very humbling. And, you know, it's great to be here, man. I'm so thankful to be in the position I am, sitting right here, man. Thank you.
Hello. Yeah. So, I mean, I'm just very, Oh, my name is Kiran Shastri.
And he's half Goan and half Bihari. He's not a crazy company, and he follows him on Twitter.
Yeah, yeah. You're my favorite follow right now. Keep it up. No, but I'm just very appreciative to be here, you know. I believe everything kind of happens for a reason, and everybody on the stage has been brought into my life kind of randomly. And, you know, I'm just very appreciative of everybody here, and especially Roy for giving me the opportunity to play, you know, after college. Basketball is what I love to do. It's really what I want to do for the rest of my life, type of thing. And Roy gave me that opportunity to play, especially now being in India, where our roots are. You know, being in this league, it's amazing. It's a lot of fun, and I can't wait for what the future has for this league, man.
The 3x3 is my dreams. I'm working every day in Brazil. I'm started the basketball 16 years. I'm played every day. I don't have too much opportunity in Brazil. 3BL give me this opportunity. For me, it's very important because I'm work too much. I work every day alone in the street, every day in the court, public court. In India, to make my dreams reality. This for me is very, very important. And together, we go another dreams, this championship, the world. I know we can.
Just to add, Leandro Lima, I saw him in 2016 for the first time in World Tour Final. Currently, he's the number one 3x3 player from Brazil. If I'm not wrong, Indy is number six in US. Kiran, you're number ninth. You're number six, number four in Canada. So we have Indian who's shining in America and Canada as well. Sorry, before you say, let me just introduce who he is. He's Vivek Singh. Vivek Singh is the first co-owner of the Delhi 3BL. He's the first, I would say, a businessman who believed in my dream.
Thank you, Rohit. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. See, all I want to say is it's a new sport. It's a new thing. And I want, basically, my job is for getting the investors and all the things. I want people to come and support the game. I want sponsors. You know, the first time the World Tour is happening in India, that's in Hyderabad next month. So I want with your channel, so at least make aware, people should be aware of that. It's in September. We want people to come and support it. And thank you very much for all of you for coming and attending the entire thing. Thank you very much.
I'm sorry, I didn't get that question.
Question before that. In the Bay, since, can you tell me how do you think 3x3 can help 5-on-5, or are they competitors? What do you think about both the formats?
Well, you know, 5-on-5 is a traditional game. You know, we grew up playing 5-on-5 everywhere around the world. 3x3 is really a street ball game. When we first started playing, anybody starts playing basketball, you play on the street, and you really start playing 3x3. So now that this game is official Olympic sport, it's a great opportunity for all the players. And to answer your question as far as the difference goes, I believe 3x3, to be a really good 3x3 player, you have to be more skilled than a 5-on-5 player. In a traditional 5-on-5 game, a really tall guy like a 7-footer can have a spot on the team. But in 3x3, that player might not be useful in this format because you have to be very skilled. You have to be able to do a lot of different things. So for us, the last 3 years, we have grown so much as players, and our skills have gone so, they have developed so much. Just because this game, man, you got to be in great shape, you got to be very skilled, and the intensity that this game brings out of you is on a different level. And I would encourage all the players, really, you know, whether you're playing 5-on-5 or 3x3, this is a game that will improve your skills. You'll be a better player, you'll be in better shape, and you know, this will take your game and make you a better player.
So much.
So I think it has been a sort of a beginning year. I can feel that there's a new language, there's a new kind of an enthusiasm, and there is a kind of realization that, well, you need to support this kind of sport because it is an expression of the times we live in. And as he said, it began from the street. And it's something which needs to be embraced by a country as huge as ours.
And also what I'd like to add here, what we kind of a point that we drove home in Delhi when we first began the league, in fact, when we had a press conference there, is that, you know, we were celebrating Virat Kohli's inclusion on the Forbes list, which we must do because he is a national treasure. But we forget that number 1 and 4 on that list was a boxer and basketball player, respectively. So when you look outside India and you look at athletes who are making that kind of money and enjoy that kind of, you know, following, it's actually way outside the arena of cricket. So why are we not giving them the space too, is a question we need to ask ourselves. Why do we cover a Bollywood event with that much more enthusiasm and not give regional cinema the due it deserves when they make better content and give us better numbers? So if it's a number game, then I think we're way up there and we stand a really great chance, like Rohit said. So I would just hope that all of you can support this dream of us coming back with a medal someday, soon rather, at the Olympics in 2020 or the Commonwealth Games. And I think at that time you can all say that, hey, we had a little bit to do to contribute to that win. So shamelessly, I am asking you to give this the place in the sun because, believe me, and truly deserves it. That's it. So thank you very much.
And thank you.
Basketball.
Basketball.
Basketball. Basketball.
Oh, wow.
Hey, what's up, man?
How strong is he? Are you?
Solo.
Hey, wait.
Badiya.
Center. You need a center, everybody.
Center.
Will it be too close if they both come down?
Okay, done.
Done.
When you do this, there's a 3x3.
Solo.
जैसे जो सवाल आपने पूछा कि इतना करेज कहाँ से आता है, भट्ट साहब मुझे हमेशा कहते हैं कि प्लीज सू मी फॉर बैड जीन्स, क्योंकि मुझे ये
विरासत में कुछ बातें मिली हैं इनको, तो मैंने कहा कि जब ज्यादा कॉम्प्लिकेशन है तो मुझ पे केस कर दिया करो तुम
कि महेश भट्ट आपकी वजह से मैं ऐसी हूँ, तो यू आर द वन रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ऑल ऑफ दिस, बट आई थिंक आई गेट दिस फ्रॉम हिम, क्योंकि उन्होंने मुझे हमेशा ये सिखाया है कि अगर इंटेंट प्योर होता है और आप सवाल पूछ रहे हैं नॉट टू काइंड ऑफ गेट एनी गेन फ्रॉम इट मॉनिटरी इन दैट सेंस देन यू मस्ट आस्क दैट क्वेश्चन एंड आई थिंक टू बी एबल टू स्पीक द ट्रूथ अब जब ये सीनियर्स को हम सवाल पूछते हैं जब भी हम अथॉरिटी को सवाल पूछते हैं वो इम्पर्टिनेंस क्यों माना जाता है आई थिंक टू स्पीक
कोई पूछता नहीं इसलिए
टू स्पीक द ट्रूथ टू अ ओप्रेसिव लीडर इज वॉट ट्रू डेमोक्रेसी इज एंड आई थिंक दैट वी नीड टू एक्सरसाइज दैट राइट मोर ऑफन
गवर्नमेंट से कितना सपोर्ट आप एक्सपेक्ट करेंगे इस पर्टिकुलर स्पोर्ट को भी आगे बढ़ाने के लिए
वेल आई मीन द पॉइंट इज दैट आई थिंक द गवर्नमेंट से सपोर्ट तो अगर मिलेगा तो कमाल होगा मगर अगर नहीं मिलेगा फिर तब भी कमाल होगा मगर रुकावट तो नहीं डालिए
मगर ये एक बात मुझे लगता है हमको एज अ नेशन समझनी चाहिए कि हर बात के लिए हम सरकार को दोषी नहीं ठहरा सकते नहीं बार बार जाके वहाँ पर दस्तक देना चाहिए आपको हाँ अगर वो कुछ उनके जो ऐसे अफसर हों जो सब कुछ जानते हुए भी खामोखाम आपके रास्ते में एक रोड ब्लॉक क्रिएट कर रहे हैं तो आप का कर्तव्य है कि आप निडर होके सवाल पूछें उनसे क्योंकि ये स्पोर्ट्स का क्षेत्र है ये बहुत बड़ी एक पूंजी है एक नौजवान पीढ़ी की और इस दौर में अगर हम एक स्पोर्ट्स की एक नई स्ट्रीम को जगा रहे हैं तो उसमें सरकार की कोई भी जो एजेंसी है वो हमको माली सपोर्ट ना करें मगर अपने ब्यूरोक्रेसी को ये तो कहे कि देखिए इनको सपोर्ट ना करें मगर इनके रास्ते में आप बाधा ना डालें डोंट हेल्प अस क्योंकि ये हमारे अंदर ऐसे काफ़ी लोग हैं जो अपने ही बल पे बहुत कुछ करने के लिए काबिल हैं ऐसे फिल्म इंडस्ट्री ने अपनी जगह बनाई इंडिपेंडेंट लोग थे सब थोड़ी सरकार के पास चले गए थे भैया हमको फाइनेंस करो तो नेशनल फिल्म डेवलपमेंट का जो प्रोसेस था वो तो भैया ठप हो गया ये हमारा खेल है हम खेलते रहेंगे और आवाम जो मुल्क की है वो मुल्क होती है मुल्क जो होता है वो सरकार से नहीं बनती है
एग्जैक्टली नो आप तरफ जैसे आपने कहा कि हम वेट नहीं करते हैं कि हमें कोई गवर्नमेंट सपोर्ट मिले फिल्म बनाने के लिए हम अपनी खुद की कन्विक्शन से खुद के पैसों से जाके अपने ड्रीम्स को एक काइंड ऑफ रियलिटी देते हैं सिमिलरली विद स्पोर्ट तो अगर वो हमें अपलोड करें हमें सपोर्ट करें फैंटास्टिक अगर ना भी करें इवन बेटर सो बिकॉज़ वी कैन अचीव फार मोर ऑन आवर ओन एज इंडिविजुअल मगर जैसे भट्टा आपने कहा कि रुकावट ना डाले प्लीज
बहुत बहुत ज़्यादा गंभीर इशूज सरकार के पास है उससे उसमें उलझी भी है सही बात है हम सिर्फ ये कहते हैं कि हमको थोड़ा सा इतना काबिल बना दीजिए कि हम अपनी मदद तो कर सकें
सो व्हाट इज द रीजन ऑफ नॉट सपोर्टिंग दिस स्पोर्ट्स
मुझे लगता है कि इसकी डिटेल से मैं वाकिफ नहीं हूँ मगर शायद जब भी कोई नई बात होती है व्हेनेवर एनीथिंग न्यू बिगिंस देयर इज एन ओल्ड गार्ड व्हिच गेट्स थ्रेटन्ड एंड देयर इज एन समवेयर इन इंस्टीट्यूशंस दिस इनहेरेंट फ्लॉ ऑफ वांटिंग टू कंट्रोल एवरीथिंग उनको लगता है कि हम सुपर फ्लोअर्स हो गए हैं हमारी अहमियत खत्म हो गई है हमारी जो सिग्निफिकेंस का एहसास कैसे होगा जब तक हम आपको
Absolutely.
रोकेंगे नहीं तब तक हम आप हमारे चौखट पे आके गिड़गिड़ाएंगे कैसे तो ये जब तक हम जाएंगे नहीं हाथ नहीं जोड़ेंगे घुटनों के बल चल के नहीं जाएंगे तब तक वो हमें देखेंगे नहीं और हम मांग क्या रहे हैं हम थोड़ी अपने निजी फायदे के लिए कुछ कर रहे हैं हम कह रहे हैं कि ये स्पोर्ट्स है इसको ज़रा आप इनक्रेज करें अगर नहीं कर सकते इनक्रेज तो कम से कम रोड ब्लॉक मत डालें बस और क्या मांग रहे हैं
बट सब स्पोर्ट्स बायोपिक इज द ट्रेंड इन बॉलीवुड दिस डेज वी सी अ लॉट ऑफ बायोपिक्स मेड ऑन क्रिकेटर्स एंड अदर प्लेयर्स एज वेल सो डू यू थिंक बास्केटबॉल द फिल्म ऑन बास्केटबॉल विल परहैप्स क्रिएट मोर अवेयरनेस अबाउट इट
वेल आई डोंट थिंक इट विल बिकम अ मेनस्ट्रीम फिल्म एज ऑफ नाउ बिकॉज एज यू नो दैट इन दिस कंट्री देयर इज अ नेशनल ऑब्सेशन विद क्रिकेट एंड ऑफ कोर्स other sports are emerging like kabaddi is getting a lot of support
yeah they're getting
from,
their due
from,
today
from a very renowned channel then you have people who are in the boxing wrestling and other sports which were not heard of are now coming onto the center stage and that is because of the enlightened media I think this attempt was to a wake up the media towards basketball and I'm certain that the younger lot wants variety because everybody wants to taste new experiences and the basketball 10 minutes experience is tailor made for the time
for the times we live in yeah and absolutely when you talk to young people today I mean 8 out of 10 youngsters below the age of 16 especially are even more avid basketball fans than they are cricket fans
yeah.
And that was, for me, was quite a surprise to find out, because I mean, that's something that they believe that they can truly achieve. So we need, the opportunity is there. The talent is there in India. We need to give the talent the opportunity to come forth and really claim their space on a world stage.
And anything that encourages this concept in the society, that together we can do a lot. Because we are getting a fragmented lot. They're getting isolated. It's a very strange irony that in the age of connectivity, we are so disconnected.
Absolutely.
We are falling apart. जितना आपके पास कम्युनिकेशन के साधन बढ़ते जा रहे हैं उतने आप एक दूसरे से मुंह फेर के बैठे हुए हैं.
करेक्ट.
आई थिंक स्पोर्ट्स के क्षेत्र से जुड़कर आप एक वो जज्बा जो हमारे समाज में था हमेशा साथ कर मिल के सब कुछ करने का, टुगेदर वी कैन डू दिस, दैट इज नीड्स टू बी केप्ट अलाइव at all levels, at all costs.
Talking about youngsters, the youth icon that everyone looks up to is of course Alia, but what's her affinity towards in terms of sports, is it basketball?
Well, I don't, we'll have to ask her. I don't know that she has, she is aware of what Pooja is now backing, but I think Alia, if she comes to know, she will give it the support that it needs, but I don't think she has a sport gene. That I'm aware of.
Well, you might not be aware of, yeah, but you,
not aware
she
of.
Has many genes. Like, for example, she had the singing gene as yeah. well that she gets from you directly.
Yeah, she had this. The sisters share this love for animals and almost to a pathological level. I mean, I have daughters who are just animal worshippers. So maybe...
No, but I do know that, you know, Alia, we have a joke in the Bhatt family that every 20 years we put a Bhatt out there. So all my fans are above the age of 35. So most of them have seen Dil Hai Ke Maantani when they went for their first date. So kind of fell in love for the first time. And they kind of look at me and they say, Hamare memories to aapke saath jude hue hain. And everybody from 6 to 26 is an Alia Bhatt fan in that sense. So there are a lot of my friends, children, even outside the country, jaye wo Pakistan ho ya wherever, and they sent me messages saying hamari 3 saal ki beti 6 saal ki beti Alia Bhatt ki fan hai. So I say, Alia, can you do a video for me please for so and so 3-year-old? And she always takes the time out, makeup free, to sit there and send it to me. So I'm certain that if I ask her to kind of support the league and support my team especially, she will do so. But like I said, I brought Mr. Mahesh Bhatt out, my ace, on the last round of the tour, which is Mumbai, because Mumbai is my city. And I feel we got such an overwhelming response in Kolkata, in Northeast, in Aizawl, for example. That's where the true basketball fans really are. They play basketball, they cheer people, they kind of really, really support them. So I said, if I'm in my town, I wanted to give 3BL the feeling, when you talk about the heart of Mumbai and the spirit of Mumbai, I said, come on, we need to give them a taste of our spirit too and cheer them like the way we cheer other activities. So I, you know, I don't put all my cards on the table at one time. Yeah. So right now, I've got Mr. Bhatt out.
Slowly, and the aces aista, will come out.
Aista, we will get everyone's support when we need it.
Abhi toh dur bhi phekhi hai, abhi ekka aane wala hai.
But sir, we don't know you is, like, you know, since you are supporting this sport, are you planning to train some of players over here, starting something like training?
They are, well, the question that you're asking is that, like Indy explained to you, that these people have been in India for the last 6 months. They are based in Gurgaon because that's where Rohit is based, and also the facilities available there, the space available there. Mumbai is not an easy city to live in and very expensive to kind of not only go from one point to the other, but it's way up there in terms of per square foot. So I think that the aim really is to kind of open institutes all across India, to have basketball courts everywhere in every nook and cranny, and really be able to kind of find talent that exists. When they talk about from the street to the court, that's where they want to go, to the grassroots level, and kind of discover this talent to be able to put them out there and compete on a world stage. So the plans are humongous, the dream is big, and the first leg of it has been very successful. Season one has been great. I'm hoping that Mumbai is a great kind of culmination to this. The climax is fantastic, and we'll be back next year with far more drama, far more excitement, far more conviction, and far more love, and we want far more support.
Pooja, coming back to Alia, we don't get you both together. Alia is doing really good. Razi recently clocked 200 crores, and she has like big films coming up. How do you see Alia's journey?
I think Alia has made us all very proud.
Absolutely.
And she has astounded me in particular, because I knew that she was talented, and she had this obsession for being in the movies. But movie after movie, I was astounded by
the variety that she's capable of.
And all her own choices.
And that's her choice. And one of the proudest things that can happen to me is that she did it her way. And I feel that she is just beginning. One thing that we have collectively succeeded in doing is to make her feel that, look, Alia, you may have achieved tremendous achievements today, but you have only scratched the surface. You have miles and miles and miles to go. Because one of the worst enemy of any person in any business, whether it is fame, glory, money, is to get this delusion that, oh, I am God's gift to mankind. Well, she is good, but there's always somebody far more brilliant, and she must keep her eye open to see that.
But people are waiting for the collaboration between Mahesh Bhatt and Alia, but when can we see that happen?
This is not a conference about about that. And I will only reveal my card. I've learned one thing from Alia Bhatt, is that if I get the gene from him about not having any barriers and no filter, especially with the media, Alia has learned that to hold your cards close to your chest is more profitable with the media, which is why on a certain level she's commercially more successful than me, because when I was an actor, I was out there and India and the world and the industry was not ready for my candidness. So she's taught me that the world does not deserve your truth all the time. But like I said, I've got his blood coursing through my veins in more ways than one. And I am going to take a tip from my younger sister and keep my cards close to my chest in this case. And all news about Alia Bhatt, Mahesh Bhatt, Pooja Bhatt, and all the Bhatt's collaboration will happen at a future date.
Will happen.
No, but sir, but social media is a buzz with...
Social media must be a buzz.
One second.
Huh. With Sadak 2 happening, it's a great moment for the Bhatt family as well as for all the fans around. Kuch uske bare mein.
Sadak 2 is happening.
What is it happening?
It is happening.
when
and how and with who is happening?
But, my question is, will you return back to direction with
it? Hello? Is it happening?
It is happening.
I don't know.
It is happening.
But sir, a word on Sadak.
No, I think we have very clearly said that Sadak is a franchise which flowered on its own after a long time. We have a brilliant script which has been put together by a writer from my friend from Bengal, Shunita, and me. Now, you will have to wait with your held breath for the proper announcement, because that is the prerogative of my brother Mukesh Bhatt.
Yes. The production house needs to announce the details of it. But all I can confirm is that it is indeed happening. And I must also say, it was Sanjay Dutt who initiated it.
Who did it?
He was the one who came to me and he said, why are we not making Sadak 2? And I said, it's not my property. Aajkal to property bulate hai na film ko. So I said, it's not my property, it's Mukesh Bhatt's property. And he said, talk to Bhatt Saab. And I went to them and I said, look, Sanjay Dutt really has this urge and desire to kind of give this light. So do you think there's any possibility?
And rest is
and
history.
They have a connection that I don't think anybody has.
Sanju and me are soulmates.
I mean, whether it's Naam, whether it's Sadak Part 1, and you know, it's just the response that he evokes in him and vice versa that actually drew this. And I think what we're really looking forward to, I was spoiled because I had the best of Mahesh Bhatt. And I had no desire to really act when he quit direction. But I think that what we are getting through this, and when I see Surita and him working on it, we're going to be going back to the times in the 90s where filmmaking was more organic and the learning was greater in between shots, where it's not these PR-generated, smoothened times without the rough edges. And what we're looking forward to is the film for sure, but we're looking forward to being there on set and feeling like we felt back in the day, because that's really contributed to the kind of people that we are today. You know, working with him was not about what happened in front of the camera, but what happened between the shots.
You want him to return to direction with Sadak 2?
Well, we don't know anything about anything. I mean,
my question is, where did he ever go to come back? He's been here all throughout.
All we are saying that Shurita and me have finished a brilliant script, and we will not be in a position to speak more. No comments has not been my way of life, but I think it is the right of the production house.
The privilege of the production house as well.
Because they are, my brother is in partnership.
No, it's his baby. It's his baby. It's Mukesh Bhatt's baby in many ways.
It is his right to go out there and decide that time and the manner in which he chooses to reveal.
And we would like to see you all again and give you all a cup of tea.
Meanwhile, bye-bye. Nice meeting you. And play basketball.
केरला की जो फ्लड आई है उसमें यूएई ने 700 करोड़
भाई केरला के फ्लड के बारे में पूरा हिंदुस्तान एक होकर रिस्पॉन्ड कर रहा है, ये एक बहुत ही मुबारक निशानी है। और हमने सब अपने अपने तरीके से जो हमारा योगदान हो सकता था हमने किया है, और ये सिर्फ एक इस हफ्ते का काम नहीं रहेगा, ये कंसिस्टेंटली वहाँ पर हमको अपनी नज़र बनाए रखनी पड़ेगी, क्योंकि ये ऐसे जब हादसे होते हैं, ऐसे जो कैटास्ट्रोफीज होती हैं, उसको उससे निकलने के लिए समाज को बहुत वक्त लगता है। और जैसे जिस्म का एक हिस्सा आपका उसको घाव लग जाए तो पूरे जिस्म का कर्तव्य होता है कि उसको हील करें, तो वैसे ही हमको एज अ नेशन विल हैव टू गिव एवरीथिंग टू केरला एंड सी इट कम्स आउट फ्रॉम दिस डार्कनेस।
इसके अलावा पाकिस्तान के पीएम इमरान खान ने भी कहा है कि हम मदद करेंगे, तो कैसे रिलेशनशिप और अच्छे होंगे इंडिया पाकिस्तान, क्या आपको लगता है?
देखो भैया, तो ये इंसान ने आपके दुख दर्द में शामिल होकर जताया है कि वो आपके दर्द से जुड़ना चाहता है, ऐसे में हमको उनका हाथ थामना चाहिए, क्योंकि इस पृथ्वी पर हम जितना भी चाहें लकीरें खींच लें, कम से कम ये इंसान होने का एहसास जब तक हमको बांध कर रहेगा तब तक ही हम सुरक्षित रहेंगे।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल।
यूएई ने 700 करोड़ देने का जो अनाउंसमेंट किया, लेकिन सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट ने उसे एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया अभी तक, तो क्या
ये सुना इस पर अजीब सा एक विरोध चल रहा है, किसी ने कहा है कि किया है, कोई कह रहा है नहीं किया है, ये तो आप लोग जान सकते हैं, आप ही हमको बताएंगे, क्योंकि आज की तारीख में रियल न्यूज़, फेक न्यूज़, प्लांटेड न्यूज़, मोटिवेटेड न्यूज़ के रूप में हम जो सीधे साधे लोग
What you see is not what you get most of the time.
तो ये हाथी के दांत दिखाने के और खाने के, और अब हमारे पास इतना वक्त कहाँ है कि बेटी की नौकरी करें और पेपर लगाएं।
बास्केटबॉल।
Lastly, we don't get you often. Social media is abuzz with the marriage of Alia. You've been a person who speaks his heart out.
I think you should be asking Alia about her personal life, not us.
I have never spoken about my children's private life. They are adults. It is their prerogative. I would never demean them, belittle them, and talk about that. That's their right. If they choose to talk about it,
or not choose to talk about it,
or they choose to be silent, it's their affair. I respect them for what they do with their life.
Thank you so much. Right way.
Pooja, acting, filmmaking, and now basketball. What do you think of the sport, and what got you here?
Well, I see the similarities more than the differences. I think that when I began my journey with Rohit and with the league and with 3BL, if you ask me what do I know on a scale of 0 to 10 about basketball, the answer was an resounding, honest zero. But I think when I watched my first round in Noida, and of course my team won, and I got a taste of blood, and I got a taste of how exciting and how thrilling the entire game and the format is. What I loved about it was the fact that initially I wondered why he was hosting it at a mall as opposed to in a stadium. But then I understood that he's doing that because he wants to make the game and the sport accessible to people. And I think that even when you look at the movies, to draw people into a theater today is a nightmare. People want to see a movie on their phone, they want to see it on their TV, they want to see it at their time. And here was somebody coming in and saying, hey, we'll bring the sport to you, you don't have to come to us. So I admire that, and that there's a learning there for us as filmmakers as well. My team I fell absolutely in love with, and I remember telling them after the first round that, hey, you know what, now you've stuck with me, but I'm going to follow you everywhere. And then he took it to very unusual places. He went to the Northeast, he went to Aizawl, where the actual screaming basketball fans actually are. Yes, and I just wish that more people came out in other cities as well. But I think I experienced Kolkata with you, yeah, and Noida, and now Bangalore, and now I'm hoping Mumbai is as riveting. But I think that also you get a feeling of the topography and the model and the basic heat and temperature of your country, because from every state to state, the fans differ, yes, the attitudes differ, yes, the response differs. So it's a great way to re-look at your very own people through a different perspective, and that is basketball. So for me as a filmmaker, this gives me the chance to leave my myopic world of entertainment, come out into a completely different field, understand and learn how little I know about this. So it humbles me, it humiliates me to understand that, hey, there's so much more that you don't know about. And an athlete and a filmmaker or an athlete and actor is not different, because we have to go out there and we have to perform with our entire beings. And we fall and we fail and we pick ourselves up and we start all over again. So there are a lot of similarities that I see in both strains. And boss, it's a conviction business. I think the world lacks believers, not talent. So he is one such believer because he loves basketball. His intent is pure. And I'm somebody who picks up vibes and intent. And I think it was his intent was something that was undeniable, which is why I got involved in more ways than just merely being a team owner.
Right.
And I'm like, my commitment is complete and full to what he's trying to achieve in India with this league. And I think it's my moral duty to help him achieve that dream, you know, because it's all of our dreams somewhere. When we see our very own shine in the world arena, I think that we all somewhere gloat about it. So why not help the process?
Right. Rohit, how has your journey been? You have Pooja, you have Bhatsa.
My journey for 3BL this year so far has been great. We had a hurdle every single state, you won't believe every single state had a different issues.
It's like filmmaking, firefighting.
We get to experience entire India, north, south, east, west. We met a lot of different kind of fans. We never thought Calcutta would be a place where we'll get a lot of engagement. One of the biggest engagement we got was in Chennai. During the match of World Cup, Azwell people came. There was about 5,000 people turned out in Azwell round in the middle of the World Cup. And believe me when I say this, Mizoram and the Azwell is a football city and a football state. They loved the they left that opportunity of watching, and then they came to watch us live. And game has been brought me to this new. I mean, you know, every single state is so new that, you know, every time we're experiencing a new
crowd.
Yeah,
the new learning each time.
New learning, new people. And this time, Maheshji is also, you know, giving us a warm words. It means a lot for us in terms of our basketballers and for the basketball community.
Right. You all want to call the public to come and watch the show if you want to say that to the camera.
Yes. Tomorrow, 2 p.m., Phoenix, Market City, Kurla. Do come there. You will see something which you have never seen before. You'll see the different kind of basketball. This is a basketball and entertainment, and the kind of entertainment you will never be able to experience. And watching it live and watching on the ground is 100x different. Mark my word, you'll have a great day.
And I will be there, so please come and watch. No, but the truth is that, yes, like Rohit says, that it's not only basketball. There's a whole lot of entertainment because the game itself is very thrilling, very entertaining. And it's happening in our backyard, Mumbai. Yep. And Mumbai is known for its dildar spirit, of its generosity, of welcoming people from every walk of life with open arms. So I would expect my town, my city, to come out there and show my team and the entire league a lot of love. So chalo Mumbai meri jaan, aajao to Phoenix Market City tomorrow and day after from 2 to 7 and cheer the entire league on.
Thank you.
Thank you.